Hi, this is Vikas Kumar. I am a computer science graduate student. This talk will describe how to achieve room layout reconstruction using a single panoramic image via spherical convolutions. This study was conducted by a deep learning group at the Pennsylvania State University. So I will describe our task in brief, that is room layout reconstruction. Given a single RGB panorama, the goal of 3D layout reconstruction is to estimate the room layout by predicting the corners, the floor boundary, and the ceiling boundary. And the end goal is to generate a 3D room layout using this panorama image. Estimating the three-dimensional layout of the room from a single RGB image has received considerable attention in the last decade. And layout estimation can present useful information like height, corner positions, or orientation of the room, which can be used for holistic scene understanding applications. However, prior work has mostly used standard convolution for encoding, and this is what our work is about. We believe that standard convolution often failed to capture features in panoramic images, thus leading to suboptimal representation. Although existing works show impressive performance for both cuboid as well as non-cuboid layouts, none of them consider the distortions that the equirectangular images contain. There is an incongruence between the panoramic images and the standard convolution networks. This is because equirectangular images, which are considered a common example for spherical image representation, have heavy distortions in them, which you can see in this image. They are especially towards the poles, and they cannot be addressed by standard convolutions. This is a bottleneck in all the prior approaches while dealing with room layout estimation. And this is the paper upon which our work is based, that is HorizonNet. HorizonNet presented a new approach to the problem of estimating the 3D room layout from a single panoramic image. They represented room layout as three 1D vectors that encode the existence of wall-wall boundary, the boundary positions of ceiling wall, and the boundary positions of floor wall. And the proposed network, which is HorizonNet, trained for predicting 1D layout, outperforms previous state-of-the-art approaches. However, it uses the common approach of using standard convolution networks. As you can see, they are using ResNet 50 for predicting the corners and the boundaries, followed by post-processing to generate the 3D layout. The proposed architecture consists of the same ResNet 50, but it instead encodes with spherical convolutions instead of standard convolutions. We remove the final phony connected layer of the ResNet 50 and concatenate the features from different levels and pass it to our bidirectional gated recurrent unit, as seen here. And it predicts the layout floor wall boundary, the ceiling wall boundary, and the wall wall boundary. In the base architecture of ResNet, we convert all the standard convolutions to spherical convolutions with inverse equirectangular projections. For spherical convolution, we use the same approach as suggested by SphereNet, and the approach proposed in that paper instead utilizes the inverse nomic projection, which maps the sphere to a tangent plane. However, since equirectangular images are cylindrical projections that project the sphere to a cylinder, the distortions produced by them are different, which cannot be handled by nomic projections. Hence, we use cylindrical projections for convolutions in our model. We perform our test evaluation on two benchmark datasets. The first dataset is PanoContext dataset. This dataset consists of 5,000 annotated cubic room layouts. The panoramas are captured from indoor settings such as living rooms and bedrooms. Based on the evaluation metric 3D IOU, we can see that our method achieves the new state-of-the-art approach and outperforms all the prior methods by 4% on PanoContext dataset. Our second benchmark dataset is standard 2D 3D dataset, and it is more challenging because it has more occlusions on the floor boundaries because it is captured in large-scale indoor environments. Looking at the 3D IOU figure, our method outperforms other methods by approximately 4% on this data set also. Thank you for listening. You can find more details about our work by following this link. And if you have any further questions, please don't hesitate to contact us.